Good evening to all of you. On behalf of my Retired Life Foundation, we welcome you for a very, very interesting talk on a very crucial topic of managing multiple medications of the elderly people, which we often do, how to manage them. And to talk on this particular topic, we have a very renowned doctor, a geriatric consultant, Dr. Nagnath Prem. He's a geriatric consultant at Just Lok Hospital. And I request Krishnamani Madam to please introduce the speaker and to please take it forward, Madam.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Prem, as Sengupta sir said, is an MBBS MD geriatric medicine and consulting geriatrician, elderly care specialist at Just Lok Hospital and Research Center, Mumbai. He also heads a dedicated one of its kind geriatric care department at Just Lok, Mumbai. And is very passionate about geriatric care, which you will hear him out. And he is very keen on spreading the word on the importance of geriatric care management and services for senior citizens. I have heard him quite a couple of times, and I'm really felt enriched and really enamored by his passion for care for elderly. And most of us are in multiple medications, definitely. So we are bound to benefit from his pulse of wisdom and advice for us. I request everyone to note down whatever they want to and ask generic questions at the end of the talk. Thank you. Dr. Prem, all yours.
Avina ma'am, thanks a lot for the introduction, and thanks a lot, Dr. Sengupta, for having me here. It's always a pleasure to talk to older adults. I am not a great believer of the words silver, senior, and white hair, silver generation. According to me, I mean, you just have an age and you live up to it the way you want to. And I mean, I think that's the way it goes. At the outset, of course, I would want to ask everybody if everybody is comfortable with English. If that is okay, then I'll proceed only in English, or I can mix it up with a bit of Hindi as well. So if that is also fine, I will go ahead with that.
English
is better. Okay, fine, I'll do it in English. So I think medication is something which everybody wants to stay away from, but fortunately or unfortunately, we are not able to do it. Why I'm saying fortunately or unfortunately, you have to be fortunate enough to actually afford the medication, and you have to be fortunate enough to actually be able to take them also, because sometimes if you have a heart disease and you don't take the medication, then you're more at risk. So that's why I said fortunately and unfortunately. So, but things work slightly differently as far as older adults are concerned. A medication acts differently if it's a younger person. Medication will act very differently if you are an older person. So all I'm trying to tell you today is try to reinforce maybe things that you already know, and try to inculcate maybe certain basic things which you should do if you're not already doing, so that you can manage your medications better. As they say, medications can be a necessary evil, but they can be tackled. They can be tackled in a better way from both sides. I'm going to give you both perspectives of how I can help you, and of course, and how you can help yourselves. So what is so much fuss about medications in older persons? Now see, we know that drugs actually go through a complex journey in our body from the time we take our medications until unless they leave our body. So basically the aging process can affect a lot of things. One is how the medication is actually absorbed in our body. It is used in our body and ultimately exists. So usually everything...
Dr. Prem, sorry to interrupt you. Sir, please, sir, 1 minute.
Yeah, yeah.
Sir, people may be comfortable in both the languages, English and Hindi also.
Okay, I'll try to mix both.
Combine both the languages.
Yeah, sure.
Some people will be comfortable with this.
Sure.
Sorry, sir, you can continue. Thank you very much.
So as the aging process happens, jo dawai hoti hai, basically body mein, it can be either absorbed hoti hai, fir use hoti hai, aur body ke bahar jati hai. So it basically exits the body. And the changes that actually jo hote hain body mein, that usually affects the ability for you to break down. तो आप जो दवाई है उसको तोड़ने में जो difference होते हैं, वो जैसे जैसे उम्र बढ़ती है वैसे वैसे ज्यादा problem हो सकता है. तो होता क्या है कि उतने ही ज्यादा टाइम दैट अमाउंट ऑफ मेडिकेशन माइट एक्चुअली स्टे इन योर बॉडी सो इट विल बी स्लोअर टू एग्जिट एंड मोर द टाइम इट स्पेंड्स इन योर बॉडी मोर देयर माइट बी साइड इफेक्ट सो दैट बिकम्स सॉर्ट ऑफ एन इश्यू एज यू गेट ओल्ड देन डोज I think as you get older, you definitely need a lower dose of medication as compared to maybe a higher dose, which might be needed in an older, in a younger person, because the effect will be different in the younger age as well as in older age. That's why we always start. I mean, there is a dictum known as go low, go slow. छोड़े दोस्त से शुरू करके हम धीरे-धीरे बढ़ाते हैं बुजुर्गों में. Then अगेन डोज मैनेजमेंट जो है वो आपको कभी खुद नहीं करना है लेट मी बी वेरी फ्रैंक डोंट जस्ट रिड्यूस और डिक्रीज इंक्रीज मेडिकेशन योर सेल्फ यू शुड ऑलवेज बी डन इन सिंक विथ योर हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर जो आपके डॉक्टर है उनसे पूछ के ही आपको बदलाव करना है डोज में देन थोड़े दवाइयां रहती हैं विच आर बेसिकली सेफ एंड सम आर विच आर लेस सेफ फॉर ओल्डर पीपल सो देर इज ऑब्वियसली यूजली अ लिस्ट which I will talk about a bit in a bit of time. But when you're taking medicines, it is important that you as an older person make sure that the correct medication is prescribed. So as we will be taking care, the correct medication is prescribed for your condition. Two is medication is basically right for your age or not. And a proper dose for the length of time. Now, a lot of times hota kya hai, there are certain medicines jo sirf 2 hafte ke liye diye jaate hain, par follow-up nahi ho pata hai, and a lot of older adults continue to take it. Kyun? Kyunki na humne pucha, na hume bataya gaya. Nahin, but it was actually written only 2 weeks. So sometimes you end up taking more. So that is also not good because certain medicines are supposed to be taken for shorter duration and certain medications are supposed to be taken for a longer duration. Dosage is very important. Then the second thing that is different in older adults is, as they say, multiple medical conditions. अगर आपको एक ब्लड प्रेशर है उसके साथ एक शुगर भी हो सकता है एक डायबिटी एक दिल का दौरा का हिस्ट्री हो सकता है यू कैन हैव अ स्ट्रोक मल्टीपल थिंग्स कैन बी टुगेदर मे बी थायराइड इश्यूज सो दैट्स हाउ द मेडिकल मेडिसिंस माइट बी मल्टीपल नाउ देयर इज समथिंग नोन एज पॉलीफार्मेसी व्हिच आई विल कम टू सो problem is there but sometimes one medical condition when you are giving a medicine it can actually worsen the other medical condition because there is no rule that one medicine is good for everything no that doesn't work that way that is working that way it would have been very nice wo bolte na ek gadi booti hoti hai aur usse sab theek ho jata I mean that waise nahi hota hai so one medicine that is given for a particular medical condition can actually worsen your other condition dusri bimariyon ko kharab kar sakte then even things like aap दवाई कैसे ले रहे हैं आर यू टेकिंग इट विद फूड आर यू टेकिंग विद वाटर आर यू टेकिंग इट बिफोर फूड आर यू टेकिंग इट आफ्टर फूड ऑल दीज थिंग्स अफेक्ट देयर अब्सॉर्प्शन आपके बॉडी में वो कैसे घुल रहा है कैसे अफेक्ट कर रहा है सर्टेन मेडिकेशंस लाइक कैल्शियम लाइक मैग्नीशियम आयरन दे आर नॉट अब्सॉर्ब वेल व्हेन दे आर एक्चुअली टेकन विद फूड्स सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी केयरफुल देन सर्टेन फूड्स कैन एक्चुअली मेक श्योर कि आपका जो दवाई है वो टूट ही नहीं रहा है सो इमेजिन अमाउंट ऑफ द मेडिसिन इन योर बॉडी इज इंक्रीजिंग एंड द साइड इफेक्ट विल हैपन बट द अमाउंट दैट शुड बेनिफिट यू इज नॉट हैविंग सो इट्स जस्ट इंक्रीजिंग इन योर बॉडी बट इट इज नॉट गिविंग यू इफेक्ट सो दैट इज अगेन ऑफ नो यूज देन द ब्यूटी अबाउट मेडिसिन अनफॉर्चुनेटली इज द फैक्ट दैट देयर कैन बी इंटरैक्शंस वन मेडिकेशन कैन इंटरैक्ट विद अनदर मेडिकेशन or one medication can interact with your body or one medication can interact with a food item so the multiple interactions can take place that's why we are very very careful as far as interactions are also concerned that's why whenever we say, tell older people ki aap jab bhi aapke dawaiyon ke bare mein baat karte hain hum aapko hamesha poochte hain ki aap kya kya dawai le rahe hain and it is not only the medicine you have been prescribed are you taking any over the counter medicine Are you taking any vitamins? Are you taking any liquid separately? Are you taking any Ayurvedic medicines? Are you taking any homeopathic medicines? Are you taking any churans? Because a lot of times, jab older adult hamare paas aata hai, unko lagta hai ki nahi, hame to inke doctor ko wohi dawaiyon ke bare mein batana hai jo inhone prescribe kiya hai. Or it is just because he's a allopathic doctor, we have to just tell him about that. No, for me it doesn't work that way. I need to know about all your medications because all medications can actually have widespread interactions. then other factors which are very important is, for example, if you have had any changes in your diet, any medical conditions that you have got recently. Certain medications have common side effects like causing you dizziness. It can cause weight loss, weight gain. It can cause changes in your memory. Aapki yaaddaasht bhi kam ho sakti. And it, ultimately, the issue is not causing all this. The issue is that it will affect your quality of life. The way you are functioning, the way you are able to do your day-to-day activities. Jo bhi aap har din karna chahte hain, usme problem ho sakti hai. To isiliye ye medication ke side effects ko man mein rakhna bahut important. Then there is something known as polypharmacy. A lot of older adults will have multiple medications. So usually hum bolte hain ki agar aap 5 se zyada medications pe hain, if you are on 5 or more medicines, it means polypharmacy. But again, it has got another thing. Something is known as essential polypharmacy and something is known as non-essential polypharmacy. Agar aapke 6-7 bimariyan hain, you have 6-7 medical conditions and you might actually have life-saving drugs which are more than 5. So you will have to take it. Basically, those medicines you might have to take. So that becomes essential polypharmacy. But sometimes non-essential polypharmacy, you only have 3 medicines which are life essential, but you have 2 types of vitamins, 2 types of calciums, 2 types of Ayurvedic tablets, 2 types of drinking syrups. Whether all of it is needed or not is the big question. So that can be non-essential polypharmacy. Just taking medical medications, whether you're getting benefit of that or not, you're not very sure. But multiple medications always include. That's why whenever I tell my older adults, I need an entire list. Whether it's your over-the-counter vitamins, supplements, herbal ointments, liquids, everything should be enlisted. Then there is something known as a prescribing cascade. Hota kya hai ki ek dawai ka side effect. Us side effect ke liye ek aur dawai. Uske side ek pe hota hai, uske liye ek aur dawai. To aise dawai dawai banke, it is from one medicine which could have been changed. Because the side effect is not okay, multiple medications can be started. For example, there is an antihypertensive known as amlodipin, which can cause a bit of swelling in feet. Very commonly prescribed in older people, very effective, but a bit of swelling in feet is there. And older adults can be very, very much, irritated by their swelling. Sometimes the swelling just goes off, it's not really problematic. But the problem happens if for the swelling, another medicine is given to reduce the swelling. Now that can cause other side effects and ultimately so many side effects happen that a prescription cascade. So for a side effect, another medicine is started and multiple medicines and then it ends up being a mess. So that I think very, very important. Then there are obviously categories in which there are certain medicines you have to avoid. Now these are the categories. One is medications and types of medications that are totally inappropriate. Matlab aapke age mein wo de hi nahi sakte. Agar denge to side effect zyada hoga. Phir aise medication rehte hain jo aap, when you have a bit of common health problems, then we should not give you. For example, if you have lot of dizziness, if you have lot of propensity to fall, then there are certain antihypertensives you should not be given because they can drop your BP suddenly and you can actually have a fall. Then there are certain medications which should be used in caution as far as older adults are concerned, especially things like painkillers. Painkillers can be risky to kidney. Then there are medications which have harmful drug-to-drug interactions. So agar wo medicine saath mein denge, to phir side effects zyada honge. Then medication should be avoided or their dose might have to be changed, especially agar aapko koi kidney mein problem hai. So there are a lot of older adults who might have problems in their kidneys. So the dosage, the amount and the duration, kitni baar aapko de rahe, wo usually hum change karte hain as far as your kidney is affected. So these are the basic categories. Now, how can you help yourselves? That's always most important. So that medication related problems are less. One is ek list banai hai. List hona chahiye jisme prescription medicines hai, kya supplements hai, sab kuch correct doses ke saath. Aur hamesha wo list leke aayi hai. Agar aapko koi bhi side effect ho raha hai, koi bhi dawai ke saath, to wo bhi likha hona chahiye us list. Aur ye list aise nahi hona chahiye jisme apne sab dawaiyan likh diye jo aap pehle bhi le rahe hai aur usko you have not striked out. If you are having a complete list, and you have medications which you are not taking anymore, strike them off because there is a chance that you might buy it by mistake and take it if you are not taking it anymore. then whatever side effects are there, watch for them. So, for example, if I prescribe any medicine to an older adult, I tell them ki ye ho sakta hai. Agar ye hota hai, to mujhe bataiye. So, you should be a bit more averse to the side effects. Then talk to your healthcare provider always if you have any doubts as far as the side effects are concerned. Now, one of the biggest questions which is always there is what happens when we are taking alternative medicine? What happens when we are taking Ayurvedic with allopathic? What happens when we are taking Ayurvedic, allopathic and homeopathic? It's very difficult to say. The reason being, none of the research trials are done in which somebody is also taking Ayurvedic medicine, somebody is also taking homeopathic medicine, and somebody is also taking Ayurvedic. Now, most of the medicines, I'm not saying because I practice modern medicine or because I'm an allopathic doctor, no. Because complementary and alternative medicine plays a very important role in older adults. But when there is research telling us that this medicine works, for example, if paracetamol tells you in research that your fever will go after taking that, your body ache will go, it is research proven. That's why you are going to take it. But if there is an X compound, which is maybe an Ayurvedic or homeopathic, and there is not a research being done saying these can be the side effects or these are the benefits, then it's doubtful. I'm not saying it will not work or not, because it's difficult for me to say. When you take this substance and mix it up with our medications, whether it's allopathic medications or homeopathic, then what mixture and what side effects will happen is very, very difficult to say. So my simple tip is always tell your healthcare provider if you're taking any alternative medicine, whether you're going to a homeopathic person, whether you're going to a Ayurvedic person, you have to tell them what all medications you are on. Always try to use alternative therapies safely. Now, the biggest problem happens is when, unfortunately, if an older adult ends up going to a quack who is not actually a person who is practicing any form of medicine, whether it be Ayurvedic, allopathic or homeopathic, they are just trying to sort of dupe it. Then we have seen patients coming with severe side effects, especially in Ayurvedic medicine where there is high metal content. So that's why we are always wary, and that's why we always say that you have to be cautioned. Of course, for example, if you have a knee pain and you actually apply an Ayurvedic oil, I don't have any problem with that, because I think I know that Ayurvedic oil is not going to cost you a risk-benefit ratio. It's not going to cost you more risk than the benefit. Similarly, a lot of older adults might take some churans, some mixtures for the constipation. Also, again, sometimes somebody will take a churan, it will help them. Somebody might take isabgul. Somebody might take just fruits with increased roughage. That will work for them. So whatever works best for you. But my only request to all of you is please mention everything that you take to your healthcare provider. Because sometimes we are like, oh, it's only a powder. What's the big deal? Why do I even mention it? Because it's not important. I itself don't take it every day. Sometimes I take it. But that doesn't make it. If you tell about it, it's easier for us to track down if you have any kind of side effects. So, okay, then make a list, but review your medications regularly. You can't just make a list and forget about it. Ki nahi, maine ek list bana diya first day aur uske baad dekha hi nahi. No. Keep reviewing it, whether any medications have been changed, whether you are taking the right dose or not, whether you need to change the list. Whenever you visit your healthcare provider, that list should be updated, whether any dose has been reduced. Always read all the prescriptions properly. Most important is instructions on how to take the medication. What have we told you? Whether it's oral, whether you have to take it before food, after food, with water, with milk, whether you need to take it half an hour before food, whether you can walk or not after taking it, whether you should take it just before sleep, potential of other medications interacting with it. Always keep looking for side effects. But again, that doesn't mean you go into Google and Google a drug and see that almost every side effect is happening. Then you will only keep thinking about side effects. Trust your doctor. Don't trust Google. Because when you do Google, what happens is what you get as the most top is the most visited website. It's not necessarily the best site. It's the most visited site. And secondly, whatever doubts you have, even if you pick it up, please clarify with your healthcare provider rather than just thinking, ye hoga, ye hoga, ye hoga. Then see, almost any medicine can cause anything. If you're allergic to some antibiotic, you take another antibiotic, you will have a side effect. You might not have a side effect, but that history is very important. So whenever you go to the doctor, you also have to mention, why always ask whether you're allergic to any medications. Because when we are prescribing, we need to keep that in mind. then always over-the-counter medications. Don't just think, I know paracetamol, buying a paracetamol, you don't need to ask your doctor and then buy it because it's over-the-counter freely available. But a lot of other painkillers are also available. So that is not something you should misuse purely because it might give you beneficial on the short term, but in long term, it can cause you more risk. Then what happens? Then once the side effects set in, the pharmacist is very clear. Pharmacy person is, now you go to the doctor. So that equal responsibility has to be taken when you're taking over the counter drugs. It is your responsibility also that you have taken it and you have to mention to your doctor. Then even when you're admitted, your medications will always be reviewed because ultimately it is very, very important that just because you're in the hospital, some minor changes might be taken. For example, if you are a diabetic and you are given IV insulin, aapko diya jata hai, toh that might become oral. The medicine might change once you go home. But for that hospitalization, maybe some minor changes might actually happen. Then I think we often keep telling that you should handle your medicines, but we don't try to highlight the difficulties you have. So let me highlight the difficulties that you might have. Very simple difficulties, which are very, very major. Difficulty reading and understanding on the labels. The print might be too small. Usme jo likha hai direction, kaise lena, kya lena, wo itna chota hai ki aap magnifying glass bhi lenge, tab bhi nahi dikhega. So वैसा भी हो सकता है. So that is a genuine problem. So that's why you need to, whenever you go to your healthcare provider, it's always better that you take another caregiver. Then very practical thing is trouble opening medicine containers. वो medicine का वो डब्बा खोलने में difficulty हो रहा है, tablet निकालने में difficulty हो रहा है, फिर डब्बा बंद करने में difficulty हो रहा है, पानी का glass निकालने में difficulty हो रहा है. These are all very practical things which will stop you from taking your medications. So you might need help for that. Then you need to ask for information about whatever medications you're taking if you have any particular symptoms. Now, hota kya hai, kabhi kabhi, what a lot of older adults say that ki now the blood pressure to control mein hai. To dawai kyun lena hai blood pressure? Dawai pressure ka le rahe, isliye dawai control hai blood pressure. So that is something you need to sort of. Of course, if your blood pressure is really going down, then you need to obviously go to the doctor and see whether the medication reduce karna ki zarurat hai ki nahi, whether you need to reduce your dose. Then side effects of certain medications, if you are worried, then you should definitely, if you call your healthcare provider, if you are having any side effects, please do not sort of keep it to yourself. Always discuss your difficulties in taking the medications with your healthcare provider, because it's very, very important. Sometimes we always keep thinking that, no, we can manage it ourselves, but no, it doesn't work that way. So now, how can I help you? I mean, as a geriatrician, as an elder care specialist, how can I help you in medication management? One is, I try to focus on education. See, I will try to educate you on whatever I can as far as your medication is concerned. And now, what all is it? One is the reason for prescribing the new drug. Why I have prescribed you the drug? What is the purpose of the drug? Kaise dena hai? Injection hai? Oral hai? Paani ke saath hai? Syrup hai? Ointment hai? Aap dusre dawaiyon ke saath ye dawai le sakte hai? Nahi le sakte hai? Kab lena hai? Kitne time ke liye lena hai? Side effects kya ho sakte hai? When to know when the medicine is not working? Aapko side effect hota hai to aapko kya karna chahiye? If there are only particular activities which you should not do while taking medications, and what the patient should do and should not do if the dose is missed. Now, ये dose वाली बात बहुत important है, because बहुत सारे जो बुजुर्ग रहते हैं उनको doubt रहता है कि मेरा morning का medicine था तो मैं dose भूल गया हूँ तो मैं afternoon में ले सकता हूँ क्या? हाँ, ले सकते हैं, लेकिन ये नहीं कि 2-3 दिन miss हो गया और फिर तीसरे दिन triple dose ले लिया, वो नहीं चलेगा. Because that will cause your BP or whatever you're taking it for to suddenly shoot down, and it will cause a lot of issues. Then modifying your regimen. Whenever we modify the regimen, we will tell you. It is our job to educate you. I have actually deleted this medicine. I have reduced this dose. I have made it half. I have changed the time when you're taking. Then always it's important that from my side, I will always discuss cost with you. The reason being, certain medicines are very expensive. certain medicines are very easily available. Certain medicines might be life-saving and expensive. So affordability becomes very important. And when we prescribe, we obviously have to know whether financially you'll be able to take it. If no, then whether we can help you out with it, because there will be organizations which can help you out. Then thirdly, we try to reduce complexity. For example, aapke bahut sare doubts ho sakte, errors which can happen is, for example, missing the doses, taking more than prescribed, zyada dose le liya, galti se ek extra dose le liya, bahut sare medications ek time mein le liye jo actually different time mein lene chahiye the, ek over the counter medicine le liya jo aapko bilkul lena nahi chahiye tha, and missed refills. Main hamesha बुजुर्गों को कहता हूँ कि आपका एक सेपरेट डब्बा होना चाहिए जिसमें हर मेडिकेशन का एक स्ट्रिप होना चाहिए, वो इमरजेंसी वाला डब्बा है. अगर आप टाइम पे फार्मेसी से नहीं ले पाते, वॉट एवर रीजन, वेदर यू मिस योर अपॉइंटमेंट योर सेल्फ, डॉक्टर इज नॉट अवेलेबल और यू आर नॉट एबल टू गो योर सेल्फ, मेक श्योर दैट यू ट्राई टू प्लान योर अपॉइंटमेंट विद द डॉक्टर नॉट ऑन द डे योर मेडिकेशन फिनिशेस बट 1 week बिफोर, सो दैट यू एक्चुअली हैव 1 week मेडिसिन. Or if it is getting too close to cut, always have that emergency dabba ready. Us emergency dabba mein bhi aise nahi ki aap expiry date mat dekhe. Wo emergency zindagi ke liye nahi hai. Agar wo expiry date near aa raha hai, to you have to shift it to your regular and make sure that you change the medications in the emergency dabba so that that also when you need it, it is not expired. I mean, then what is the use of actually having it? Then we always try to provide and recommend sources for you. For example, the name of your medications, how you have to take it, कितनी बार लेना है, कितने time के लिए लेना है, dose क्या है, कौन prescribe कर रहा है, उसका purpose क्या है, what is the most common side effect, what you should avoid, whether खाने के पहले लेना चाहिए, बाद में पानी के साथ ले सकते हैं, नहीं ले सकते. Then technology, I mean the biggest thing which is now important is technology can help you. जैसे आपके मोबाइल फोन में स्मार्टफोन रिमाइंडर्स हो सकते हैं, कंप्यूटर में रिमाइंडर्स हो सकते हैं, और वो रिमाइंड इतना करते हैं कि आपको लगता है कि इससे अच्छा तो दवाई ले लेते हैं. They will keep reminding you, take it, continuous reminder, half an hour before, half an hour after. So such reminders can be set, and there are specific pill reminder apps as well, which will be helpful, which actually help you in reminding you that you have to take the medicine on time. Then another important thing is we as doctors would love to conduct regular medication reviews. That's why I always tell all the older adults to bring all their medications, ideally 1 month strip also, along with the list of medication. The reason being, sometimes the list will not show the content. And if we know immediately that the content is an issue, I will tell you, no, now you need to stop it. This is the one which is causing side effect, so do not take it anymore. So that is also something which is, I think, very, very important. Then, of course, in a nutshell, if I have to say that how will you ultimately help yourself? As far as medications are concerned, one is fill your prescriptions. Agar hota hai, to ek pharmacy mein. Ideal nahi hai. Kabhi kabhi some medicines are there which might be not available in your pharmacy. You might have to go to another one. But so that they also know these are the medications, and ultimately it becomes easier for you to refill whenever that date comes. Or else, sometimes if you have to go to a new pharmacy every time, you're not sure. Then secondly, always try to use a pill dispenser. For example, pill dispenser mein morning, evening, night, a lot of caregivers who are actually working and they are taking care of older adults, they might just keep the medicines in the pill dispenser and you can take it morning, evening, night. But in that also, it's very important that you as an older adult know what medicine you are taking. You cannot just remember it by the size of the medicine, by the color of the medicine, by the shape of the medicine. Because galti se apne galat dabbe mein dal diya, to fir wo galat dose galat time pe ho jayega. Then apart from that, use your reminder system, whether it's through technology, whether it's writing a note on your fridge, whether it's writing a note in your board, whether it's writing a note in your diary. As simple as writing a diary, this is my medications. Medications have to be taken at this time. And just keep doing it timely. Again, please get your prescriptions filled early, at least 1 week early. Never get into a shortage and emergency situation where life-saving drugs like antihypertensives, anti-diabetics have to be skipped by you because it's not available on time. So try to always go 1 week before and always try to have at least 1 or 2 weeks extra of medicine. देन मेक अ लिस्ट ऑफ ऑल योर मेडिकेशंस एंड अपडेट कीजिए उसको, कौन सा चल रहा है, कौन सा नहीं चल रहा है, कौन सा डोज कम किया है. द प्रॉब्लम हैपेंस इफ यू आर गोइंग टू मल्टीपल डॉक्टर्स, बट दैट डजंट मीन यू ओनली राइट in different pages. Have a single thing wherein you have all the medications, fine, you can know that these are the antihypertensive, these are the antidiabetics, ye sugar ke liye hai, ye heart ke liye hai, ye thyroid ke liye hai, ye gas ka dawai hai. Because it has happened with people going to two doctors, taking two types of vitamins, two types of calcium for nothing. It is just double medicine which doesn't help in any way. Two types of blood thinners where only one blood thinner had to be taken. So those things you only know when we see the medicines. And why we stress on medication list is because there has been, we have cured patients only by reducing the medicines. There was an older person who was an 82-year-old who was admitted with us, who came with 30 medicines. And they came with something total delirious. Kya baat kar rahe hai, kuch samajh mein nahi aa raha hai, kuch ajeeb ajeeb baat kar rahe the. And ultimately what happened? Over the course of 10 to 15 days, we were able to reduce it to 5. But that was done in time. Again, remember, aapke jab sab dawaiyan rehti hai, to khat khat karke aap immediately sab band nahi kar sakte. Kyunki lingering effect rehta hai body mein. Dose thoda kam karke hi band kar sakte thodi dawaiyan. So then there was a sea change. So that's why they say medication is not always the sort of, the treatment in older adults, yes, for conditions it is, but sometimes you might actually have to reduce them. Then there is something known as an yearly brown bag review. Brown bag ka matlab ye hai ki aap ek brown bag patient ko hamesha rakhna chahiye apne paas, aur usme sab dawaiyan strips jo hote hai single honi chahiye, aur hamesha jab bhi aate hain wo bag aapko doctor ko dikhana hai ki ye medication hum le rahe hain. Itna yaad rakhiye, medication ka management jo hai वो सिर्फ डॉक्टर का रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी नहीं है, वो आपका रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी भी है. द रीजन बीइंग यू आर द वन हु इज गोइंग टू टेक दैट ड्रग, यू आर द वन हु इज गोइंग टू हैव अ गुड इफेक्ट और अ बैड इफेक्ट, वॉट एवर इट इज ऑफ द पर्टिकुलर मेडिसिन दैट यू आर टेकिंग. सो यू आर इक्वली रेस्पॉन्सिबल एंड इवन इन सम केसेस इवन मोर सो, बिकॉज इट्स योर हेल्थ विच इज गोइंग टू बी अफेक्टेड. So even if a doctor tells you, please don't take this, don't take that, and you still continue to take it purely because it takes, provides you better relief, then you should be ready for the consequences. That is the only thing I'm saying, because a lot of older adults have severe pain. They take painkillers in spite of the doctor not telling them. And ultimately you come with a renal problem, then it becomes very difficult. You have to remember, when you're already having aged organs, and on top of that, you have side effects, it becomes difficult for the side effects to go away quickly. Sometimes the damage can be permanent as well. That's why be very vigilant with your medicines. Be responsible yourself. And do not shy away from asking questions. I always sort of answer all the questions regarding medications to older persons. And I tell mostly about the side effects beforehand myself. I tell them. But if you still have doubts, try to ask them. Now the most common query that older people have is that the doctor will not always have the time to tell about all the medications. Usually I do. Some people might not have, not because they don't want to, because there is another person waiting after you to get help. So in this cases, but there is always a teammate who can help you. For example, the pharmacist can help you. And pharmacist has that job. He has to help you in understanding a medication if the doctor is not entirely done. Usually, doctor will tell you the entire prescription. If you have any doubts which you forget, you clear it off with the pharmacist. And it's very important that the instructions jo aapke bag mein rehte hai, usually bags mein milte, wo likhe rehte hai. Morning mein lena hai, evening mein lena hai, night mein lena hai, kaise lena hai, oral lena hai, nahi lena. Aur us instructions ko unko boliye ki aap, they should write it in legible letters, big size letters, if you have any problem in reading. Because ultimately, or else what happens is, ye pura dekh ke ghar jaate, fir suddenly realize hota hai, are kuch dikh bhi nahi raha hai, kaun sa dose kaise karna hai, and then it only sort of leads to your confusion. So try to clarify it with, if not with the doctor, but with one of the team members, and they will be sort of trying to help you out. Another thing, as I told, I want to reiterate is, do not just keep referring Google. Try to refer websites which are actually helpful. There are official websites for medicines. Again, if you are a layman, which you will be if you are checking out those websites, don't go into too much of medical details. They will only scare you. try to get those details and ask your doubts to the provider. A lot of times what happens is older adults or any, even for that matter, caregivers go on the online, see it. They are like, oh my God, these are the side effects. Yeah, wo hai. Dawai chhod dete. No, you can't take that decision. If you're on a medicine, which is going to be life-saving, if you're on an important medicine, try to talk to your doctor and then only try to change anything. Don't try to do everything yourself. Another thing is, if you have any side effects, please let them know immediately, because that is when we need to sort of reduce your dose, try to increase the dose, or try to stop the medicine completely. For example, whenever an older adult is prescribed something for sleeping by me, I'm very clear, if you're feeling very drowsy taking the next morning itself, you please let me know. We might have to reduce the dose or we might have to not give you the medicine, because that's the way it is. Another common mistake which is done by older adults is if there is a spouse, ek older adult hai, unki wife hai, wo wife le rahi hai blood pressure ke liye dawai aur aapko bhi blood pressure shuru ho gaya, wohi dawai le liyo. Nahi, wohi dawai aapke liye kaam karegi, kisne bola hai. तो वो ऐसी एंटी हाइपरटेंसिव वाली दवाई आप खुद नहीं लेना चाहिए, आपको डॉक्टर को दिखाना चाहिए और उसके बाद वो प्रिस्क्राइब करते तो ही, बिकॉज वो जरूरी नहीं है कि वो एंटी हाइपरटेंसिव वाली दवाई जो आपके वाइफ के लिए चल रही है या हस्बैंड के लिए चल रही है, दैट विल वर्क फॉर यू ऑल्सो. सो दैट इज समथिंग ऑल्सो जो आपको दिमाग में रखना है. बी वेरी कॉशियस विथ योर मेडिकेशंस, बट एट द सेम टाइम बी रेस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर देम. डू नॉट शाय अवे फ्रॉम आस्किंग क्वेश्चंस टू योर हेल्थ केयर प्रोवाइडर, बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली वी वॉन्ट यू टू बी सेफ विथ योर मेडिकेशंस. Medications will help you out in a lot of cases. Yes, they are life-saving. They will help you out. But unnecessary medication should always be deleted, because ultimately they will only help you to live a better life, because medications can have various side effects. So thanks a lot for your patient hearing. If at all there are any questions, I'm more than welcome to.
There are some in the chat. So either... Yeah. We can read it out, or somebody can one by one ask him also. That's
yeah. So, Doctor G, can I ask you one thing? Can I ask you, Doctor G? I'm Miruna.
Boliye.
Four vitamins presently I'm taking, and one BP medicine, 5 mg BP medicine. Four vitamins are calcium, vitamin B and D vitamin, and I vitamin. So, what time generally we should take these vitamins?
Ma'am, I would say we should refrain from specific questions here. The reason being, I do not know what all medications you're on entirely. So it will become very difficult for me to assess and say it. So I would say maybe we should keep it for another platform. It's better to actually ask generic
questions. Yes.
Okay. Can I ask one question,
please? Can I ask one question, please?
One by one, puchhiye.
Agarwal sir, pehle puchhe na. Agarwal sir, puchhiye.
See, doctor, I would like to know from you, I am an 80 years old man and I suffer from this constipation in the sense that the stool is very, very hard and it doesn't come in the normal time, but it comes the next day. Now for this, I have been taking Tripla also. I have tried even Isabgol also. Now Livolac also is being tried. Now, are these safe to be taken over long term, or is there anything else that can be done? Because this hard motion is what is bothering you. You have to apply a lot of pressure and the stool is hard.
So what kind of diet do you take?
It's a normal vegetarian diet with lot of fibers and even leafy vegetables also and fruits.
Okay, do you take good amount of water?
Yeah, I do, but the problem is I can take water during the day only, because in the night if I take water because of my urination problem, I've got a hyperactive bladder.
So you need to make sure you take plenty of water before 6 p.m. And yes. Not take a lot of water. So basically finish the quota, 1.5 liters, whatever you want. 1.5 is good enough for your age. And you take it before 6 p.m. See, constipation is very relative for everybody. There are older adults who actually go once in 2 days also. But that is because that has become that particular sort of habit. It's not something which is alarming. But I would say if you're able to pass your stools properly with taking Trifala or this syrup or maybe even Isabgol, there is no harm in it, because these are very mild drugs. The only thing you can say with constipation and the syrup is sometimes you can have too many loose stools, so you need to sort of make sure the amount that you take is managed. But you have to be mobile. For constipation you can't be mobile.
I walk 2.5 kilometers.
Yeah. So you have to continue that. Yeah, you have to continue that as well, because it's not only medicines which will help your constipation, because age-related slowing has happened. Diet, lifestyle, along with the medications will help. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. Nitya, madam.
Doctor, hello.
Yes.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah. I was prescribed this sleeping tablets by my psychiatric doctor. So how far it is useful for me, like whether I should take or not, because I've not yet started. And one, because once some telling me if you start one, then that means it will go on. I have to go on taking daily. And without the doctor's advice, I cannot stop also. So, but is it safe, doctor, with this medicine, this one? It is Miraz or something.
Again, ma'am, I think it's a specific question, but let me give you a general answer for it. See, it's there are two things. You want to sleep, you don't want to sleep. If you take a medication and you don't encounter side effects and you get good sleep, there is no harm. But if you take a medication, you get more drowsy and you actually have more side effects, then the medicine will cause you harm. So I would say it is best that if it has been prescribed by a doctor, try to get in touch with him. Try to get to know more about the side effects. If you're worried about it and you're not going to continue, please let him know and then take your decision. Because yeah, I think no. that would be the best way to go for you.
Yeah, I saw on the Google, no? It is put this medicine as that.
Exactly. That's what I'm telling you. You can Google anything, but ultimately, I think you should clear it up with your doctor. And then only try to take it.
Nay, and since I'm alone, no, I'm getting frightened to take this medicine, because if I fall down, if I get dizzy or anything, then it will be a problem for me. No,
definitely your concerns are very genuine because you're alone. So I would say if you're scared of taking the medicine, it would be better that you get in touch with the doctor who has prescribed you and then try to take a best solution forward. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, doctor.
Uday Acharya has raised his hand. Please ask, sir.
Yes, ma'am, this is Acharya and Mrs. Acharya, doctor.
Hello, sir. Hello, ma'am. Tell me.
Are you saying that we have to look at the prescriptions and also, we can ask, but most often that the prescriptions of the doctors is their handwriting is never understood by us. And we don't know when we take it to the pharmacy and they will say, this is it. And then we don't know the alternative. They say, "Yena filter hai, toh ye alternative." So how do we tackle this? And when we ask the doctor also, sometimes when we take the time to ask the doctor, sir, this is not very clear. Can you explain? So some doctors do explain, but most people will say, "Oh, pharmacist, samajh mein aayega." Okay, so we are left with a very big question mark out of the clear. But the fear, and then when we also ask them, "Hey, sir, what are the side effects? Or for what you're giving this?" So he will only tell us one thing, that no, you take all this and you meet me after 30 days. So how do we tackle the doctors also with this kind of a thing?
Yeah, so as far as the handwriting is concerned, I don't think we can do much about it. I've been blessed with an okay handwriting. I wouldn't say it's a great one. But more and more doctors are getting digital now. So handwriting gets out of, it completely goes out of the window. And you get typed prescriptions in most of the cases now, purely because of the COVID also. And before that also, purely because then it becomes more of something which we only edit it in a Word format or whatever PDF, so that it becomes But I would say is, as far as clarity, I can only speak for myself. So as far as I am concerned, I give a lot of time. I give a lot of time to my older adult, in which I have to explain all the medications when I end and usually end my session. I mean, when I see them, and I explain the side effects as well, if any, and I try to address their questions also. Now, I said that it's not that the doctor does not want to address it. It's just that there are more people waiting purely because you have to end up addressing other people also. So what I would say is, as far as the alternatives are concerned, when you go to a pharmacist, it becomes slightly a dicey proportion, because what happens sometimes, we as doctors want you to take that particular brand because we are experienced with it. We know it will act better, and it is not available, and immediately the pharmacist will tell you, nahi nahi, iska side yahi hai, ye le lijiye, ye bhi utna hi acha. But in that case, I mean, what I do, because I also have relatives who obviously take medicines. So they ask me, or I ask other doctors, whether I can sort of take that alternative. Because it's important. If it's a paracetamol and Crocin, then that is not a big judgment call here. But if it is something as an antihypertensive, in which we know that this medication is better than this, as far as the company is concerned, then I think it is always better to get that. Now the pharmacist, pharmacy person is different, and the pharmacist is different. Because the pharmacy person is obviously looking at the next customer. Not that he doesn't want to give you, he will give you, but he will not necessarily explain you. That's not the way it happens abroad. In abroad, the pharmacy person has to actually explain to you everything. Here in hospital pharmacies, everything is absolutely explained. That is something I know for sure, because there are trained pharmacists in the hospital where it will tell you, this is the dose, this is the amount, this is what you should take. So I think at that time is where the clarity you need to get. If you still have doubts after going back, then of course it is best that you try to get in touch with your healthcare provider again. If not, if he or she is not available, then your specific relative doctor who could sort of help you, because that is also a better way of tackling it. Because I mean, it becomes sometimes very difficult for older adults and their relatives if they are not able to ask immediately. You're fair enough. You can have doubts later also, which can be sort of cleared. But the lack of time and not doing is something which is very relative to different people. I seriously can't say why or why not, because ultimately that's the way it goes.
Sir, can you
may I ask one question, madam?
1 minute, R.K. Modi sir, you wanted to ask something?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sir, please go ahead.
Actually, in the beginning, he told, whenever you go to your doctor, you tell everything, problem, and if you are taking some medicine, maybe allopathic, maybe homeopathic, maybe Ayurvedic. But I have generally found that when we say that we are taking this Ayurvedic, this homeopathic medicine, they are not very happy. And I'm telling you frankly. And they say, oh, I don't know this medicine and this potency of this medicine, so I cannot tell you what to take. So then he prescribes this allopathic medicine if I'm going to allopathy. So you have told that you should tell everything, that what medicine you are taking. So are you taking this care of this Ayurvedic, homeopathic, and then allopathic?
No, sir. I can't take care of all the three faculties anyways, purely because I am not trained in Ayurvedic and homeopathic. But I need to know it purely because then I will know the doctor who is taking care of you and who has prescribed you Ayurvedic and homeopathic. At least I can discuss with him, because he is that particular practitioner who has given you. So that is very important, because once you don't develop side effects, everything is fine. But once you have side effects, we need to see whether it's purely because of allopathic, whether it's purely because of Ayurvedic, or it is because of all of them together. Now this all of them together becomes a mystery only, because it's very difficult to delineate which medicine was taken together and that is actually caused. So a particular faculty person will only be able to help. That's why another thing that I always ask is, which are the doctors you are consulting? Because if I need to actually sort of coordinate with them, and ultimately it's a teamwork. If you're an older adult, you might have seen other doctors as well. So we will have to coordinate with them, and that is when you will be able to sort of help you out. Now, if you're saying doctors just simply refuse, saying that they don't know, they are saying it because they don't know. To be very frank, yes. they are not knowing what the Ayurvedic drug is going to do. So that's, I think, something they're frankly trying to say. It's not because they're trying to shun you off or trying to say that you should not take it. Yes, I know of certain doctors who just get irritated. They're like, Ayurvedic medicine, kya leke aaye ho? Yahan kyun dikha rahe ho? But that is relative, sir. That is relative. Everybody will have their own perspective. As far as I know that, see, ultimately, I can only talk about what I know. So if research says that this drug works, and I'm convinced with. That's why now that Ministry of Ayush is coming with more research. So we will know if those Ayurvedic compounds will work. See, when modern medicine was not there, people were still treated. My problem is with quacks. My real problem is people who actually sort of act as practitioners and just give gullible people medicines which just destroys their health. And ultimately, when they come to us, it becomes very difficult to salvage. So that is something which I've encountered quite a bit. And you know, elderly are vulnerable population. So they are I'm just purely saying, just the thing that ki nahi main ye aap dawai le lijiye usse better ho jayega, hospital jaane ki zarurat nahi. That thing itself sometimes puts them into that, and when the side effects come, it becomes very difficult to handle. So I think all doctors should be more receptive. There is no doubt about it. But at the same time, it could be purely because they don't have the knowledge of Ayurveda or homeopathy, so they can't comment on it.
Yes, sir. Second.
Hello, doctor.
Modi sir. Modi sir. Please. Swapna madam.
Yes, sir. I would like to ask you. You spoke about emergency box. Can you elaborate a little on that?
By emergency box, I meant all your medications which are there. They should have a strip extra.
In case of emergency,
that is what I meant as far as your box for. I didn't mean emergency medicines wala box. I meant a box which has a strip of your medication. As far as emergency medicines are concerned, I mean, as at your level, you can only keep very basic medicines like a paracetamol because most emergency medicines are prescription medicines. You can't just have, unfortunately in India, you can get antibiotics over the counter, but ideally they should be prescribed. And even if you have something for your chest infection or your abdominal infection, you should, whether it's for loose stools, you should have it under prescription. So if you call it an emergency box, maximum you can keep is only maybe paracetamol and things like that. But what I meant by the emergency thing for your regular...
One strip of everything.
One strip extra of everything. Why? Because that becomes an emergency. If you have a shortage and your BP is shooting up, and if you don't have that medicine at that time, then you are in trouble. Because then it becomes an emergency.
Hello, sir.
Mine is a very general question. Hello, sir. Are you able to
listen? Yeah, please go ahead.
Mine is a very general question. If we take some medicine for years together, suppose 4 years, 5 years, 6 years, they say there is a myth that our body becomes resistant to heat and we should shift to some other derivative of the same ingredient. Is it like that? Because I'm already taking some medicine for the last 4 or 5 years. And I don't have any problem with them. So whether we should shift to some other derivative of the same ingredient?
Sir, not really necessary. It is obviously varies from case to case. I'll just give you an example. If you have blood pressure, and then if one medication has worked for 5 years on the same dose and your blood pressure remains normal, I see no reason why I wouldn't continue the same. But if your blood pressure is actually fluctuating, in the sense that even if it is getting lower, then I would want you to monitor your blood pressure and see if it is actually consistently low, and I will try to reduce the dose also if needed. So it's both ways, reduce also and increase. Now, when do we actually go to another derivative or another medicine is when there is no control. If we do not usually wait for one particular medicine to the maximum dose and then go to the next medicine in low dose, no, not like that. Sometimes we have to start different medicines at the same time. But then that is, to be very frank, relative. If you have one disease, it becomes easy, as I told you. But most older adults will not come with one disease. It could be 4 or 5 diseases where one medicine can cause issues with others. So then that can be sort of a difficulty.
Thank you, Dr. Sir.
Yeah. We'll take one more question. Bharat Bhushan ji, you wanted to ask something?
Sir, can I ask? Yeah,
please go ahead.
Doctor, you talked about affordability and all that. No, what's your take on generic medicine?
Yes, I want to.
Yeah, I mean, it's a good question because I can answer it because I worked in AIMS. So I have prescribed generic medicine. I worked in AIMS for more than 5 years. So I actually have prescribed generic medicines, and people have actually been benefited with it. So see, generic medicines are not some inferior medicines which are being given to you. No, they are not. They are basically just cost-effective medicines which have been created by the government so that a broader population can get it. It doesn't mean that it is inferior. Now, the only thing is, when we prescribe you a certain medicine which is of a certain brand, it's not because we want to promote that brand. It's because we have belief in that brand. A lot of doctors might get irritated with you saying that I had told you to buy this particular brand, but you haven't. It's not because, array, he must be benefiting from that. No, that is just a general notion. No, it's because we have belief in that brand. Whereas what is a generic medicine? Generic medicine will only be a content. Basically, if you're on a drug which is known as amlodipine, it's got amlong, it's got so many names, different brands, but amlodipine is the content. So what you will get in AIIMS is amlodipine, whether it's 2.5, whether it's 5, whether it's 10. So that's generic. But what has been created in a branded version, if it is superior to the generic medicine, and I know it is superior because purely because of experience. We learn through our experiences when we actually prescribe drugs. So then we are able to sort of know that this is working and this is not working. So do not feel it is inferior, because a lot of times affordability is a very big question. I mean, and it is something which cannot be neglected. It is something which cannot be neglected, and especially more so even in older adults, purely because sometimes they might be self-dependent, sometimes they might be dependent on others. And sometimes it might be just that they have enough money for this particular and that particular thing. We have had patients like that where it becomes really difficult. So we obviously try to help them in the best possible way that we can. So I think generally don't be under the impression that generic inferior. They are basically good, but of course they are available. I mean, if it is shocking, for example, somebody saying I'll give you a medicine at a 90% of a cost, then I think that is something which should hit alarm bells. It's not necessary that actually it is so costly, but then it is being sold in such low prices, then that is something which has to be sort of, and this doubts won't come with paracetamol. If you have a paracetamol of government and you take a dolo, you believe in Crocin because it's been there for years. So that's that sort. So as patients also, you get used to certain medicines and they might work for you. And maybe when you take a generic, it might not. So you will be like, the generic is inferior. Oh. Not necessarily because it's inferior, it's because it is not working for you. And something else.
Okay. Thank you.
Adagandi.
Sir, 1 minute, sir, one doubt. And so what is the ideal time gap between a diabetic medicine, BP medicine, and the multivitamins? Generally, we take all together.
Yeah.
Now,
that
again,
is the biggest problem, because we generally 6-7 medicines have to take.
Again, ma'am, it depends on what anti-diabetics you're taking, what antihypertensives you're taking, and what vitamins. Now, vitamins are much not of an issue. Vitamins are not going to cause you a lot of side effects, but your anti-diabetics might, or antihypertensives might.
Diabetes and hypertension, can you take together?
It again depends on which medicine, ma'am. Certain anti-diabetics have to be taken before food. Certain anti-diabetics have to be taken after food. Most antihypertensives can be taken after food. Certain antihypertensives should not be taken in the night.
Can it be taken together, at a time together?
Again, ma'am, you have to give some gap. Give some gap. Okay. It could be a very minimal gap. It's not necessarily you have to wait half an hour. It could be
five,
maybe
5-10 minutes.
10 minutes. Yeah. Because see, 4 or 5 medicines is a risk for you also. I don't want the medicines to go in your lungs. So that is another thing which you have to, because the amount of water you will take will also be more, and you will try to literally force yourself taking into those 4 medications. You have to be careful.
Thank you.
Hello.
Yes,
doctor.
Last question. Please go ahead, sir.
Thank you. Doctor, I have been prescribed a 4 mg Coversil per day. But if sometimes 4 mg is not available, the pharmacist gives an 8 mg. Which is the correct way? Taking it on alternate days or take half tablet each day?
Again, sir, it's specific depending on what other medications you are taking and what other diseases you have. For example, sometimes if you are on a statin, which is usually for lowering your lipids, if you are on 10 mg and you have to take it and we want to reduce it, sometimes we make it 5 mg or alternate day. to see, I mean, we make it 10 mg alternate date to see. Now, as far as potency is concerned, sir, it depends upon basically if you are prescribed a 4 mg and you that is enough, so you should take it daily. If you are,
because pharmacist does not have a 4 mg pack, he gives me an 8 mg pack. What is in such situation?
It's not, it's no harm if you take alternate days. It is not going to harm you in a big deal.
Okay. Thank you.
Excuse me, doctor. For that tablet cutter comes, that is very good. And you can cut the tablet also in two parts. I have but that. And all, I have,
but not all tablets can be cut.
That not all tablet, but mostly we can cut it. Nowadays it is available in India also. Someone brought it from USA. But nowadays, doctor, it is available in India also. That is a small thing and it's a very nice thing. Tablet cutter.
And certain tablets, ma'am, should not be cut.
Okay.
Because their potency reduces.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you, doctor. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much, sir. Dr. Prem, I think we had a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful session.
Hello, doctor. Sir. Hello.
Many questions. Bharat Bhushan ji, I bank kar raha class. I bank kar.
Sir, mere ek sawal tha chota sa.
Abhi baad mein after the class kar lijiye. Main aapko email de dunga. Unka aap unse kar lijiyega. So I think we had a wonderful session.
Thank you.
Many of us would have many more questions to ask, but unfortunately, the time is going a little bit beyond our this thing. On behalf of all of us, we extend a very, very hearty thanks to Dr. Prem for running a wonderful program. Thank you, sir, very much. And look forward to seeing you again for another session.
Thank you, doctor.
Bye bye.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Excellent.
Thank you, doctor.
Nice presentation. Good session. Thank
nice
you.
Nice and very informative. Thank you,
informative.
Doctor.
Informative. Vaheguru.
Lots of doubts are get cleared.
Thank you, doctor.